I'm sorry I haven't. I'm sure he'll turn up, though. He's a wanderer.
I'm really worried. Kane! Come on! Kane! Kane!
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape. Yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite.
We're all watching out for you.
What happened to the good old days when you robbed some nasty folk, have a party?
Lots of things happen.
Arthur. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Oh, he ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems
to have lost his mind. I know.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
How are you?
About how I look.
Okay. Are you perhaps available for some work?
Debtors?
Yes.
I guess.
Your commitment to your duties is admirable. You know, Mr. Morgan, you are... Well, I'm sorry for you. Hmm? No, never mind. I didn't...
Look, Strauss.
You take care.
I ain't dead yet.
No, of course not. That's what I was saying. I...
The debtor, Strauss. Who owes you money?
Well, there's a deserter from Fort Wallace. Head to him first. They're looking for him out on the road near Three Sisters. Man's name is J. John Weathers.
J. John Weathers.
Then there's a miner over in Annisburg. He's called Arthur. Like you.
Huh.
Arthur Londonderry. Family man, desperate. You know the type.
Couldn't one of the boys do this?
I tried. They lacked your vigor.
Vigor, huh? All right.
Take care, Mr. Morgan.
Yep. Hello, Arthur.
Arthur.
Susan?
Someone smashed the box.
What box?
The money box. We'd had that for so many years.
Why did they smash?
I don't know. Look at this place. All divided. Everyone anxious and at each other's throats. I'm heartbroken.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Let's go, boy.
Oh, hi, Arthur.
You okay? Easy, whoa. Yep. Whoa, whoa!
John Weathers.
They call me Snow Goose now.
Whatever they call you. You borrowed money off of Leopold Strauss. The bills come due.
This ain't the best time, sir.
This ain't the best time for anyone.
Mr. Strauss knew it was a long-term proposition.
The debt is due.
Okay. I got supplies meant to last through the winter. You can take them. Just, is there any way you can help me? I stay out here. There won't be anyone to pay you.
I ain't here to help. I'm here to collect. We're all of us up against it.
Look, there's men after me. They're killers. I ain't a deserter, just an objector. It ain't right. If there was another way than running, I need your help.
Shut up.
Please. I...
Up here. It's him.
It's too late.
Form up. We shoot on sight.
I clear off, sir.
Shit. Well, seeing as I'm here, may as well protect the payment.
My darling, you can come out.
Oh, crap. I probably should have helped you fix the damn wagon.
We could probably still save something.
Really now?
Look, you can take the silver locket for the debt.
Damn the debt. Just get her somewhere safe. Go on.
Thank you, fella. You know, there ain't enough kindness in this world, that's for sure. But you...
I don't know nothing about kindness.
Idiot.
Can you help? Can you help me, mister?
What's the problem?
My goddamn horse got spooked and run off.
You hurt?
Not too bad, at least. But he took my damn leg.
Sorry.
He went that way, I think. His name's Buell.
Buell?
Second time a prick named Buell cost me a leg.
Huh?
Buell was my general when I lost it.
Okay.
Anyway, if you see an angry bastard of a horse with my wooden leg, I'd be real grateful.
I'll bear that in mind. Calm you down. Take it easy there. Easy. It's okay. Whoa, boy, easy now. Easy. You're okay. It's okay, boy. Whoa, now, easy. Whoa. You're okay, boy. Easy. Easy there. Easy, boy. Easy. Easy there. Easy, easy. Hey, easy now. Easy. And easy. There we go. Hey, now. Come on now. Easy. 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 Go easy. Come on now. We're easy now. Go on. Get you back. Yeah, he's just where you left him. Can't go far with that leg in your stirrup. Can't go bucking him like that. So you better be good, you hear? I get the notion he's not a man you want to cross. No matter how big and strong you are. Spook you here. Come on. You're not so nasty. I found him.
You're a good man, mister. Mr.
Arthur. You're right. He's a brute.
Hamish Sinclair. Yeah, he's a great horse, aside from when the devil got him. Hey, you want to hand me that leg there, please? And while you're at it, give old Buell a kick for me, would you? No, I'm only kidding. Thank you. Warren, but a snake that spooked him. You're a real gentleman, you know?
Sometimes, maybe. Yeah, how'd you lose a leg?
Oh, in the war. Cannonball. Pretty clean, though. I don't have much pain, and I didn't get any gangrene. A young boy went into battle with me, got cut in half, so all things considered, I'm doing pretty well, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. So, how is the false one?
It's okay. I can still hunt, fish, enjoy the outside. Weren't sent too crazy by it. Anyway, I ain't got much to pay you with.
You know, that's okay.
You like fishing? You come with me someday. I know some pretty good spots.
I'm a pretty poor fisherman.
Yeah, well, I'm great, so between the two of us, we do okay. My cabin is right over on the other side of O'Cray's Run there. Thanks again. You throw me again, you old dumb bastard, I'm gonna put a bullet in you. I'll see you again.
Time to go, boy.
Yeah. faster.
That could liquefy each of your internal organs in turn and leave you just a puddle on the floor.
Professor, I ain't here to rob you. It's me. I helped you at the pond.
You did? Oh, you did. The buffoon. Hello.
Hello.
I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Of course you are disturbing me, buddy. I almost solved biggest problem and you mess it up!
Did?
No, but I did. I can't get the bloody conductor straight. The geometry of life. The grand theory of power. It's the grand theory of theories. There is just one more big problem. Maybe I solve it, but I can't get it right.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't. Help me adjust these things, and I will show you what I mean. Here, take these.
I'm not much of a scientist.
Yeah, well, you are an American. Science is far beyond you. But you make a fine buffoon. Go.
You have the detector in your hand. The filament flashes when it points at the location for conductors. Follow flashes up in hills and plant conductor rods where filament goes solid. When all three conductors in place, lightning strikes the rod, and we harness power of
wonderful!
I wish I ever went to school so I had a clue what was going on. What now?
Well, now, I come to second the creature after God himself to bring life to this earth. Like this!
Am I missing something?
The switches. The bloody switches. Okay. Climb up there and adjust them for me. Go quick, please. Second time? More like 7,000. This is my life's work. It is incredible. What? Creation's second birth.
I just saw a machine waddle a few steps.
I have a son. I am the luckiest man alive. Those morons! They doubted me.
I'll see you later.
Yes. Yes. Goodbye.
How you feeling, ma'am?
Much better than I felt in a long time. If we hadn't caught that rabbit, I don't think I'd have made it another day.
Well, you look better.
Better and determined, thanks to you. And if I'm gonna learn to hunt, I figured it was time I learned how to use Cal's gun properly.
Well, how's that working out for you?
Well, let's just say my prey is looking decidedly unscathed. But the end of labor is to gain leisure. Is that not what Aristotle said?
Well, I don't know much about Aristotle, but I know a thing or two about shooting a gun. Look, you gotta hold steady and firm. You just focus, breathe slowly, and always pull the trigger on empty lungs. Here, I'll show you. Okay. Calm and steady. Don't snatch the trigger.
You make it look so easy.
All right. You try now. Remember to breathe.
Wait to breathe out. Wait to breathe out. Would you look at that? I haven't hit one that close all day.
Not bad. Focus on the inhale. Shoot on the exhale. My turn. I'll shoot a few more this time.
Oh no, that wretched rat is back. Over there, you see? It's been a thorn on my side ever since we moved here. Kill it, please. Got away. I told you it was fast. Anyway, my turn. Come on, come on. Yes! I hit it! I hit it, didn't I? What can I say? Thank you. I still have some of the rabbit left that I salted up. Would you join me for a meal? It's the least I can do. Go ahead and take a seat at the table. Food is just about done. Oh. Well, it's good and hot. I hope you enjoy it. You helped me to catch it, after all. Bon appetit.
Huh?
Please enjoy. And thank you again for everything. I really am grateful.
It was nothing.
You're a good man.
Oh, you don't really know me.
I know enough. There's always more to find in ourselves. You helped me to see that. My husband, Cal, was such an optimist. I found that to be very contagious. But there's a fine line between optimism and naivete. And we were both born with a silver spoon. Banquets, butlers, valets.
Sounds terrible.
It was just so many people, so many things. I was lost in it. I was crushed by it. My father was very overbearing. Then we came out here and I got crushed by this. You know, I pictured myself picking fresh vegetables, sipping homemade wine, writing a great novel. But I turned out to be a far more pathetic anti-heroine than any I could ever pen.
Oh, well. I reckon you're gonna be just fine.
Are you all right? Can I get you some water?
No, I'm fine. I just, thank you for this. I think it's best if I make...
Stay right there. It's gonna be okay. My dear Arthur, I have gone out hunting. Not a phrase I thought any pen of mine would ever ink, but nonetheless one I am very proud to finally be able to write. I am so very grateful to you for all the help and encouragement you've given me. There is some money in a box on the nightstand. Please take it. I have far more than I need back in the city, and I'd like you to have it. Please take care, and remain true to the man I know you are.
Let's go, boy. Yep. Okay.
What? Yeah! Yeah, you all right there, boy? You're a good boy. Yep. Whoa. Whoa, easy. Yeah.
Excuse me, pardon.
Hello?
All right there. You got any business at the mine?
I'm looking for an Arthur Londonderry. I was told he works here.
Londonderry? Oh, you'll want to speak to the foreman. He's down in the pit.
Arthur Londonderry. Is he here?
I'm sorry, feller, but you're too late. Arthur's dead.
The man's dead. What's wrong with you?
Oh, boy. You can't exactly beat it out of him now, can you? You might get something off his widow just across from Butcher's Creek, but I'd hurry. You ain't gonna be the only one a-knockin'.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Hey, I ain't the godforsaken moneylender.
Okay, Phil. Mrs. Londonderry.
Arthur's dead.
I know. I'm sorry for it. It's just... we lent Arthur some money, you see, and...
So it was you. Son of a bitch. What do you want now? You want my boy's shoes? You want the food out of our bellies, what little there is? You want me to lie down for you?
No, no.
Arthur gave everything to pay your bills. Everything. And now there's some fellas coming to take the house. There ain't nothing left, mister.
I guess I was just coming to say that... that's canceled. That's it. Good luck, ma'am.
Well, thank you. I just wish you'd done it before he worked himself into the grave. But you know, maybe you and your friend that lent him the money could do things differently. Like, not threaten a man. Excuse me.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I really am. Yep.
Thank you.
Giddy up. Yep. There. Giddy up. Ah!
My brothers might be able to help you.
I got the horse.
This is Murphy Hill.
How did you get on, Mr. Morgan?
Just dandy. Mm. Just... get up.
What?
Get up!
What is wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Nothing at all.
What are you doing?